want to see some real interaction?
Y'all want to give y'all that fluff shit. I don't like you.
I might want to, hey, you might go with Melo.
Can y'all post this and put a magic marker on, black magic marker on this?
No, it's cool, because I'm talking like this. So, I'm LBJ, King James, LJ, LeBron, or, you know, what?
You got that video when you was trying to, with the marker? So, the reason we here.
This D-Wade, Dwayne, Chi-Town. Really? Oh, you don't call
it's
you Dwayne?
Not Dwayne.
That's how it look when it's rolled down?
Look, we gonna dunk.
Okay, you gonna see all the high flying from the both of us.
Nice passes.
Right.
Cause I'm gonna be like this, and Bron gonna be like this. Dude, roll it.
Suave on a beat.
Stephen, I wanna ask you this. Where do they rank all time?
Like to know that it's going to be a long season, and
those are things that make me feel alive. Being on that big stage, being in those moments. I miss that. I miss being in my room, not talking to nobody, feeling like, you know, the world's on my shoulder and then coming out and showing what I'm made of.
There's a little bit of this, but Bledsoe is new with this team. And it's under pressure. Wait, Josh! Oh, it's a three! Oh, LeBron James cannot believe it! 105-104! Now Cavaliers within one!
Plenty of time with that shot clock.
Way again!
Steal here, Hubie.
Got him.
The alley-oop, LeBron.
There it is.
Peanut butter and jelly. That was eye contact as soon as he passed us right here at half court.
One more look at that dunk, though.
Yeah, this is just a strong move. Great pass, LeBron. He, right in front of us, Wade turned his head to see where LeBron was on the other side. Just gave him a glimpse, and then, you know.
Ahead and poke it out. Durant from Wade. Welcome back. Here's Wade setting.
D-Web, you wanted it. You called it. You said it was going to happen.
And here's off the backboard. The old teammates. Back-to-back champion Miami Heat. Wade County to LeBron James.
With the fourth pick in the 2008 NBA draft, the Seattle Supersonics select Russell Westbrook from UCLA. With the third pick in the 2009 NBA draft, the Oklahoma City Thunder select James Harden of Arizona State University.
What did you view your role as when you arrived?
I felt like I should have been the starting two guard, but it wasn't the case. I came off the bench, so once again, I just had to be humble and just continue to work.
Harden spent his first three NBA seasons here, becoming a star for Oklahoma City, building a bond with two of the league's budding superstars, Russell Westbrook and Kevin Durant. As the team trended upward, the Thunder's coach suggested a change.
Scotty Brooks came up to me and said, "Do you want to start?" And I told him, you know, no, because we had a chemistry. My role was to come off the bench, and that was for the better of the team.
In 2012, at the age of 22, Harden became the second youngest player ever to win the NBA's Sixth Man Award. He helped lead the Thunder to the NBA Finals. OKC seemed poised for a title.
What did you think your future was with OKC?
That I was going to be the Sixth Man. Forever.
Forever.
But OKC's contract offer was $6 million less than the league maximum. It came less than a week before the 2012-13 season was to begin.
Why didn't he accept the offer?
It was like an afternoon phone call, so like 4 o'clock, and I had until, you know, an hour or so to make my decision, you know, whether I wanted to take the offer or not. And I'm thinking to myself, you know, this is the most money I've ever made in my life, and you're giving me a short amount of time to decide, and it wasn't enough time for me.
That same night, Harden got a phone call from the Thunder general manager.
Sam Presti called me and just said that, you know, sorry, we love you, but You know, we've traded you to the Houston Rockets. That was, you know, a very, very sad night.
What'd you think when the phone call ended?
I went home, laid down, and just started tearing up. We had big plans that we were gonna, you know, win a championship for years. That ended quick. It's been almost 4 years and I still think about it. What if, what if?
What's the answer to the if?
It stops, and then I think about now.
The case for him.
Okay, he averaged a triple-double. There's only one other person in the history of the league that ever did it, so. I mean, he's doing it every single night. I mean, on every aspect of the floor. I mean, it's we're watching greatness right now.
I think it's amazing to see somebody average 25-plus points, 12-plus assists, 8 rebounds, team third in the West. I think it's amazing, especially to do it with the team he had, go over there and kind of have his own team and, you know, move to the point conferences. I think he's doing a great job.
All right, now Russell's the 2-time MVP of this game. Might be going for that three-peat tomorrow. So who gets the triple-double tomorrow?
Both.
Two triple-doubles.
Two in a game.
How about that?
Reuniting with Russell Westbrook makes them incredibly formidable. We understand that Russell Westbrook hasn't looked the way that we're accustomed to seeing him look, but he's fresh off of 3 consecutive years of averaging a triple-double. He's still an unstoppable force one-on-1. He can't be guarded. He's bigger, he's stronger, and faster than Chris Paul, not to mention a little bit younger as well. And so you take that into consideration, along with the fact that his relationship with James Harden is pretty close because they're former teammates in Oklahoma City.
My reaction was the Rockets' title window, which appeared to be closing, if not closed, sprung wide open last night. They move off of a 34-year-old Chris Paul for a far superior, if not flawed, 30-year-old Russell Westbrook. They now have 2 of the last 3 league MVPs in the same backcourt.
I mean, I'm excited, man. I mean, it's a new chapter, but I know he's excited. He's been in Oklahoma City for 11 years, so it's a new chapter for him, and welcome him with open arms, and I mean, it's gonna work. It works. It's that trust factor. You know, I trust him, he trusts me, and, you know, obviously with the group that we already have, and, you know, the things that we've already accomplished, it should be an easy transition for him just to, you know, be incorporated right in, and things should be able to go.
Can't fuck with you, too fake.
On the block, I ain't make it to dinner. In the trap, I got my old plate. Leave it wet like a tub when I'm in her. I fuck it up, now she in love with a nigga. Make it high in the middle of winter. I took a loss and that's what made me a winner. We too fake, I can't fuck with you niggas. Can't fuck with you too fake. On the block, I ain't making the dinner. In the trap, I got my own plate. Leave it wet like a tub when I'm in her. I fuck it up, now she in love with a nigga. Make it high in the middle of winter. I took a loss and that's what made me a winner. If I call you my bro, then your bitch is untouchable, nigga. I ain't touching the nigga. You pass me that chop, I ain't bluffing. I'm busting a nigga. I'm busting.